Welcome to another video. I want to talk about my Ledger Nano S that I've had sitting here for about 9 months, and I think it's about time to crack it open and set it up. Instead of using software-based wallets where I keep the key, like Electrum, for instance, right now. So let's jump into the setup of a new Ledger Nano S. Set it up. It is a Nano Ledger hardware wallet. Allows you to keep your cryptocurrency on a hardware device where you get to keep the private keys. You control it, no custodian whatsoever. So this actually comes with the hardware key. Also, there's instructions and a little slip for your seed because we will initialize our address and keep the seed itself. So we'll write down what that information is here in our instruction manual, and we're getting started. Okay, and this is the recovery sheet. And we're going to put our 24 passphrases once we get that created. It also comes with a little lanyard to carry around with you on your neck, and even a key ring, and a micro USB. Okay, so now we're at the welcome screen. I just have it plugged in and it's not connected to any network yet. So let's go through the setup. There we go. Little welcome screen. Okay, so we want to configure the device. Now I'm going to do code here. So let me change this here. So next we need to configure or confirm. So we hit the two buttons again. Okay, so now step three, time to do our start phrase. So let's take care of that. So now we got our recovery form. I'm not gonna show you the pass keys there, but now we got to verify that. So that's our next step. Okay, now we just pass key in the questions. And now our device is ready to go. So you can see here, I've got Bitcoin and Ethereum, and we can go into the settings by hitting both buttons at the same time. That's how you get into it. I like the brightness, I'll keep that in there. I don't want the rotate screen. And probably do need to get a firmware update. It's been out there pretty old, so we'll take care of that. And we'll get some coins put onto this. So let's get this hooked up. Okay, that was pretty easy to do once we got all the 24 word phrase complete. Now I have the Nano S connected to my computer, and I went to ledgerwallet.com, and here we are. So what I'm gonna do next is go and bring up our management console system. So let's get that started. Click on get the app and install. I'm going to click on Add to Chrome. I'm going to pop up our Ledger Nano Manager. Okay, next let's go and type in my PIN on my device. Well, not type, but select it. Okay, now I'm starting to set up the device. First, I'm going to check for firmware, and I have a 1.2 if I recall, so let's go ahead and install that 1.3. Okay, now I selected OK, and now on the device it says processing. Next, I have to confirm. Now I'm a version 1.3.1. This is on the device, not on the screen. So I'm going to click the checkbox as we went to the right button. Now it's updating. And still is updating. All right, now we're ready. So this actually restored completely bungled up my configuration. So I have to go through my restore of my configuration. Luckily, I have that written down, so let's take care of that. I'll be right back. It looks like it's enforcing a new security policy with a 8-digit PIN instead of 4. Hey, I like this better. Now that we actually got connected, now let's configure that. We'll take a look at our firmware. All right, looks like we're good. Go to our applications, and I want Bitcoin. I will allow that. Here we go. And we're going to go down the list of apps and install the ones that I need, like Dash, and Litecoin, and Dogecoin, and Ethereum. We'll get those all going. Next, I'm going to use the Ledger wallet, add that to my environment. And I got that just by going to the Ledger's website, and then went to Ledger Wallet Bitcoin, and that's where it'll take you to get that downloaded. Okay, let's go ahead and launch the app.
And there we go. Go ahead and unlock it here. Now that I have it unlocked, I'll open up Bitcoin on my wallet. There we go. Yeah, we're going to use definitely Bitcoin. And remember that. Select legacy. Let's bring up my Electrum wallet. Go send this here. 0.01 Bitcoin. Why not? There we go. And off it goes. We'll take a look in just a sec. Go to minimize this. Go ahead and close that. Look at that. That was pretty super quick. Literally, probably like 10 to 15 seconds, but unconfirmed, that's really good. Okay, I'm going to do Litecoin next. There we go. Yeah, definitely do SegWit. Perfect. Now that we got it running, we're going to go and receive some Litecoin. I'll send one Litecoin to this address. Do this real time. Okay, let's send some Litecoin now. Go ahead and hit send. Click on yes. There she goes. Boom. Wow. Nice. I'm happy now. So there we go. I hope you enjoyed that walkthrough, and I'm going to use my Nano Ledger more for my cold storage. And thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Ooh, Bitcoin's $6,300. Hey, that's great.